Video blog, beautiful fucking mountains, beautiful day. Gonna talk about not taking things personal. What's up guys, Jay here to talk to you guys on my first video blog. We're here at Lake Elizabeth in Fremont, California. That's actually Mission Peak behind me, which is actually the tallest point of the Bay Area. And yeah, it's a beautiful fucking day out. Amazing, amazing. There's tons of people out here walking, enjoying the day. So I decided what a beautiful day to film, you know? So what I want to talk to you guys about today is not taking things personal and how much of an important role it is to your growth and your development to not take things personal. What made me want to pick this subject is that I see people in my life that are just beating themselves up, man, off of things that everyone goes through. I'm talking about situations that everyone will have to go through sooner or later in their life, whether it's regarding your career, whether it's regarding school, whether it's regarding relationships, whether it's just basic, anything a human will go through in their life. And I see people that I know that just beat themselves up over things that are just normal to go through. And now, the importance of not taking things personal is that you take a step back from basically your ego or the self-image that you have of yourself, and you detach yourself. So when you choose to take things personal, you attach it to your emotions. And the minute you attach it to your emotions, you get caught in a spiral. Now, what you want to do is learn to not take things so personal. That way you can take the step back, understand that this is not a personal experience. This is a universal experience, meaning that tons of people have to go through this experience, and you're just another one out of millions and billions of people who've gone through these experiences. And once you realize that, you can kind of take a step back, detach yourself emotionally, look at what you did right, look at what you did wrong, and calculate your steps so next time you can learn from it and do better. Cool? This is a perfect place to make love, make passionate, sweet love. Okay, so I want to give the example of a few famous people that you probably know that chose not to take things personal and actually gained a whole lot of credibility from it and really just influenced millions and millions of people. The first one I want you to think about is Michael Jordan. Now, Michael Jordan, in his high school years, he didn't make his high school basketball team. Now, I want you to think about that. Michael Jordan, I'm talking about the most boss basketball player you can think of in the history of basketball. He didn't make his high school basketball team. Now, when this happened to Michael, what happened? He got very upset, of course, like anyone would, especially loving a sport so much. But what Michael did is, after he went home and took all of his emotions out, he chose not to take things personally. He said, you know what? This doesn't say anything about me personally. This is actually something that I can use for myself. So what did he do? He took those emotions from losing that, and he went out and he practiced more and more every day. And then he ended up making his basketball team, and he ended up being one of the most influential basketball players ever on earth. Another person I can think of is Muhammad Ali. I heard a story that Muhammad Ali's teacher told him he would never be anything. Now, when Muhammad Ali won his first Olympic gold medal, he went back and gave it to his teacher, who told him he'd never be anything. Now, that's incredible. But what did Muhammad Ali think about himself? He thought he was the greatest. He didn't let what other people dictated about him tell him who he was. So you make your own standard for yourself and don't take it personally. Now, a few things I want you to try out is put yourself, for example, if it's a relationship, put yourself in the other person's shoes. Now, when you do this, look at yourself from their perspective, or whoever, whatever situation, your boss or whatever, look at yourself from their perspective and be honest with yourself. And when you do this, you can pick apart your flaws and you can see where you're doing wrong and what you're doing right and how you can improve. And that way you come back harder than you ever were and you won something. Understand, you never lose. You always win or you will learn. It's a very million dollar habit right there. Please engage in that. A few other things you can do is meditation. You can sit, watch your thoughts, watch your emotions, see how you're feeling, why you're feeling, and also realize that whatever situation you're in is very temporary in this whole realm of things and the whole scheme of life. It's a lot bigger than what you think. And second of all, you can talk about it. So talk about it with friends, talk about it with family, talk about it with just people you end up meeting. And you'll realize that usually the situations that you take the most personal are the most universal. So, meaning tons of people have gone through it. It's just a normal thing to do. It's a natural progress of life and growth is going through tough situations. Another thing you can do is start going out and trying new habits and new things. Go try a new sport. Go do a new hobby. I don't know. Go join a new community or club. Get out there. Show yourself what else is out there so that way you expand your world and then your other problems don't seem as big. You'll find yourself getting better in no time. But once again, step back. Don't attach to the emotion of the moment. Understand this is a temporary situation that you can learn from and grow from. Vital to your growth as a person, and analyze the situation, be extremely honest with yourself, once again, but don't beat yourself up, don't take it personal, realize it's a universal cause, all right, and you'll be fine, and you'll grow much stronger. Once again, this is Jay, out here at Lake Elizabeth, a beautiful fucking day, it's so beautiful, can't even explain to you, fucking sun hitting my skin just feels so nice. But all right, guys, thanks for watching. See you guys next time.
I might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold. I love you. You'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know. Too afraid of my heart to let you go. Waiting for the fires you light. Feeling like we could do right. Be the one that makes tonight. Cause freedom is a lonely road. We're under control.